Thank you, Gary. This was my third trip to Zambia. I thought that visiting the water projects and the people would have less impact on me this trip, especially since I knew that we would be visiting a few villages where I had been before. Boy, was I wrong. Returning to some of the same areas enabled me to see the huge progress that had been made in just a few years. Instead of getting a brief look at the conditions there, kind of a snapshot, my experiences this summer filled in the much bigger picture, which was begun 2 and 4 years ago. One example is my story about a woman named Endless, and a lot of you have heard the story I told about her 2 years ago at this same presentation. When we first met her in 2008, Endless was with about 10 women gathered near a dirty pool of water. Some of the women were washing clothes in big buckets of sudsy, very sudsy water. And when they finished, they dumped their water, suds and all, back into the dirty pool. Endless was crouched over a shallow hole about 8 feet from the main pool. The dirty water from that pool slowly seeped into her hole there. She was patiently waiting, holding a long-handled pot. When enough water was in her hole, she carefully scooped it into her 5-gallon jug, just like this one down here, and waited till the next group of water, next batch of water seeped in again so she could repeat that process. While she worked, with the help of a translator, I asked her a variety of questions. Endless has 6 children. At that time, 2 years ago, 2 of her children had diarrhea. She understood that they were sick because the water she was giving them was bad. She said she had no alternative. She walked about a 1/2 kilometer each way to the water bowl, and she made between 6 and 8 trips each day. Each round trip took about an hour. So she spent 6 to 8 hours every day of the year, collecting water. In my trips to Zambia, I've talked to other women who had similar stories. But Endless's story is unique because throughout our conversation, her face was like a mask. She spoke softly, hardly moving her mouth. She showed no emotion. She never smiled. Like her name, she seemed to be on an endless treadmill with no hope for anything else in her life. The image of her blank face has haunted me for 2 years. Now, fast forward to this past August. One of our first stops was at Endless's village. We didn't have to drive back to the more distant old water hole. There, close to Endless's home, was a brand new well. And next to it, it still makes me cry, next to it was a large group of villagers, all of them singing and dancing. As we drove up, I had no trouble spotting Endless. She was right in the middle of the group, dancing, singing, and smiling. When we talked this time, she said her children were now well. She said she now has time in her day because the well is so close to her home that she or her children can get water quickly and easily. I could see it on her face. Endless now has hope for the future. What a gift it was for me to see the changes in Endless and in the others in her village. It was as if Endless had been freed from a prison where she had a strict regimen which required her to get water 6 to 8 hours every day of the year. Now she has more time to care for her family. Eventually, she can plant a garden to provide more nourishing food to her family and to possibly raise some extra money. I no longer see Endless's mask-like face in my dreams. Instead, I remember the jubilation and hope that was clearly present in August. I think you can sense the same feelings as you watch this video of the celebration.
Thanks for the well.
They've been here since 1975. They've been drinking water from the river, from the stream there. Even after a heavy rainy storm, they would just come down here and collect from the ponds around here. So she's so thankful that she's able to take safe water here. That's why she's saying Darumba. She's saying she's run out of words, and she's so thankful for the well.